You know, we passed down iron skillets in our family, like money and jewelry and whatever else you got of value. So this one actually was not passed down to me, but I have one from both of my grandmothers. I have one from Granny that's a little smaller than that. It's about this big, and I only use it for cornbread. I don't know why, but I think that she always used to make her cornbread in it, so I just use it for cornbread. This one I don't really care about, so I'll cook anything in it. Let's see. Hey, girl. Anyway, and I have another one, a small one from my ninny, and she was the sweetest lady, really, probably the sweetest lady that I've ever met. She's very kind and sweet, and I never, ever heard her say a bad thing about anybody. I really did not, and I mean, really, how can you go through life without saying something bad about somebody? That's a good thing. Okay, I'm going to get a plate for the sausage, and then we're going to get on gravy. I'm just going to put it on the baking plate, because that's a waste of a good paper plate. Broke. Maybe I should use my thing. I'm getting rushed now. I'm gonna make mistakes because I'm trying to hurry. We're just having all these kids and having two sets of twins. I had to learn to do stuff in a hurry sometimes. Okay, so now we're gonna add this bacon grease to that pan. I know it's not the healthiest thing in the world, but boy, it's good. And we don't do it all the time. It creates memories. Hold on, I have to get a can of evaporated milk. Okay, so just gonna bring my flour over here. I mean, you can use self-rising or all-purpose. I don't really think it matters. I usually just use whatever I have out. And what I like to try to do to know how much flour to put in is I kind of put all my grease to one end, and I kind of estimate about how much grease that is. And then I try to add about that same amount in flour. Y'all, even if y'all don't watch this video on how to make this biscuits and gravy, I know that my family will, and my kids will always have their mama on camera making their favorite breakfast. My niece told me the other day that she learned how to perfect her banana pudding recipe by watching my videos. So once you get the flour in, it's really important that you get all the lumps out. And this little spatula, metal, with the little slats, are really good for this. I wish I'd had this when I was a kid. It was always my job to do this right here, to stir the flour and get all the lumps out. After I oiled the biscuits, of course. And so, and then it also cooks the flour. You don't want to taste raw flour. Anyway, but also I have to get the evaporated milk in there, and then we may add some whole milk too. So yeah, it was my granny's banana pudding recipe, and I have that video. Maybe I'll add it to the end screen of this video if you want to go watch that. So now we have all the lumps out. That looked about, I could probably add a little bit more flour, but sometimes when you do that, it locks up on you. It gets too thick. But now would be the time. Maybe I've talked myself into it. Maybe just a little bit more. Maybe about, just that much more. That's not going to hurt anything. It's not going to lock up on that much. And I don't know how much all these kids are going to eat. I mean, kids usually like biscuits and gravy. I know some of my Idaho nieces and nephews love it. And I know at least one of my sisters-in-law love it. I always try to make it for them when they're here or when we're out there. Okay, so that's good. And now we're going to add our milk. And I like to add about half and then make sure it's all good. And then add the rest. And then this won't be enough. We're going to have to add some more. I think I may just go get another whole can, because you can add whole milk, but if it's really cold, like it's just been in the fridge, that kind of makes it lock up. It's better to let your milk come to room temp. So I think I may just go get, I'm really starting to thicken up already. I'm going to go get a can of milk real quick. This is a finicky stage. So we have one more, and you could even add water, a can of water in here after you had the can of milk if you didn't have enough milk. This will be really good and rich. I love evaporated milk. I use it for my mashed potatoes too, and it doesn't expire. I mean, eventually it expires, but it doesn't expire as fast as milk you have it, the fresh milk. Okay, so I've got it on, I had it turned to low while I ran and got the milk. So now I've got it back up on medium. And this, the great thing about cast iron is it really holds its heat and disperses it evenly really well. So that's looking like good gravy. Get my eggs started in a minute, but I don't want to walk away from this gravy. So now I'm just looking for the lumps, and there were a few little lumps that were like little actual pieces of sausage. Now some people cook up their sausage and then they like ground beef, they crumble it in the skillet, and then they just make the gravy in there with the lumps of the sausage in there. I don't really care for that. I mean, I'll eat it if that's all that's available, but I like it. I like to do it this way. Okay, so now we're gonna put some salt. And I'm usually kind of stingy with my sea salt, but I want everybody else to get some minerals too, so I'll use a little bit of that, and then I'll use regular old salt, and it's just, however much you want. And I'm still working on finishing my coarse ground black pepper. And I like a lot of pepper. You may be thinking that's crazy, but it's gonna be good. So what I'm doing here, I think it matters how you stir it. All I used to have at Granny's house was like a wooden spoon, and she would always tell me to use the back of the spoon and go like that right there. And I used to like make designs and stuff in the pan while I was doing it before the milk got in. But you want to push everything down to the bottom and then stir it. That way you're making sure that you don't have any of those lumps. It's just gross to get a big lump in your gravy. And that's probably just really good. Now, if it starts to thicken up out of control before everybody gets here, I'll add more milk to it. And it doesn't matter if it's cold or not at that point, because it's a good gravy now. You can save it. I mean, if it gets too thick, you add more milk. If it's too thin, you just cook it longer. And everybody has their own thickness and thinness that they prefer. I don't like a really thick gravy. I like to be able to just freely pour it over my biscuits. So we're just gonna let that, every now and then I'm gonna come in and give it a good stir, make sure it's doing its thing. And here's the good thing, if people are eating it and it looks like it's going down and you're not gonna have enough, add some more milk to it. It's easy to stretch this. In fact, yeah, that doesn't look like enough, so I am gonna add more milk. And I don't always have whole milk. I usually have 1% or 2%. Or if I'm doing the low carb, I have heavy cream. So I just pour a little bit more in. And sometimes I start the stirring with it like this, but then I always finish it with turning it down and going like that. So see, this is mixing in really easy. Maybe a little bit more. Maybe a little more. I just don't know how much they'll eat. Okay, so it's too thin now, but the longer it sits here and cooks, it'll be just the right consistency, I think, by the time everything is done. They look really good. They're going to be done in 15 minutes. I think they were a little smaller. So there they are. I can hold this one closer because doesn't weigh as much. Now on to the eggs. It's the last thing. Yay! I found these little Rachel Ray's, whatever they are, skillets. And I think Ollie's or something like that. They're really good. I really like them. Of course, it may just be that the non-stick is still on there and it hasn't been rubbed off yet. They're not that old, although they're a couple years old. They've held up very well. So if you guys see any of these orange Rachel Ray cans, I think you would like them. Okay, so we're gonna put some butter in here. Let that be melting. So I have 12 eggs. And I put just a little bit of milk. Okay, so I have it on in between medium and high. I just take from the outside and pull to the inside. I don't know. I don't remember anybody ever actually teaching me how to make scrambled eggs. Maybe I saw it on TV or something. And there probably is a better way. Maybe I should look that up. But, I mean, eggs are eggs. They turn out okay. In fact, I think they turn out pretty well. In fact, I think, you know how you go on vacation sometimes and they have those omelet bars? I'm pretty sure I could get a job doing that. I'm a pretty good omelet maker. If you don't mind them a little messy. Usually it's because I try to add too many of the toppings in it, and then it gets heavy, and then when you go to flip it, it kind of comes out of its little form. All right. Gravy is still good, and when I turn it up to heat it up good when everybody's ready to eat, it'll thicken up just right, I think. It's pretty milky right now, but if I turn this up, you'll see. It won't take long to heat up and to thicken up. Here's the good thing. After you cook all this, you're really not even hungry anymore for it. So I can just... This is the cooking diet. But you know what? I'll eat it anyway, even though I'm not that hungry, because it tastes good. It tastes really good. So I like when you pull it in like this, and then you see a little clump forming. That's kind of satisfying. And I've heard different things on when to salt it by different cooks on the cooking shows and things. As one guy said, you don't salt it till the very end because it makes them tough. But sometimes if I wait till the very end, I forget about it and don't salt them at all. So I salt them whenever I think about it. In fact, I'm gonna do it right now. Use a little of the sea salt, a little of the regular salt. And for some reason, I love coarse black pepper on everything except for scrambled eggs. And then I use just the regular table pepper, black pepper. I like to see the little flecks of black in there. It makes me think it tastes better than it does. I used to really hate eggs. I mean, I eat them now. I don't love them. I mean, but they're, I like them a lot better than I used to. But like, I would, I don't know that I would ever like crave. Although, no, you know what? That's not true. I actually have craved eggs before, but not for the taste. It must have been for the nutrition or something. So I just tolerate the taste of them and the texture. I guess I need to start getting people rounded up for breakfast before it gets cold. In fact, I probably ought to stick those biscuits back in. So I'm probably about 5 minutes away from being completely done. You know what, we're gonna taste, we're gonna do the taste test. So this is the regular buttermilk one. Okay, so let's see, this is the buttermilk one, and this is the one with the vinegar. Can you hear that crunch? See, so it's crunchy up underneath there and all around the side, and then in the middle it's nice and fluffy. I tell no difference. That's good to know. Little Bear, what about you? Do you tell a difference? She'll eat anything. And that's good to know. I've never actually tested to see if that actually will work. And it does. Editing this down, guys. I'm so sorry. I may do it in parts, part one and part two. This is really going to be hard to edit. Oh goodness, I need to turn these down because they're setting up. So they are really almost done. Even though there's a lot of liquid, it won't take long. Maybe I should work on a thumbnail. I'm really not good at these. Okay, so here we go. I should do the pictures, because actually I don't really know how to isolate the video to make a thumbnail out of it. I need help. I need some technical person. Okay, so this is going back down. As you can see, the gravy is now thick. Just right. I haven't tasted it. Probably needs some salt and pepper. Yep, I was right. It needs just a little bit more salt, a little bit more pepper, or a lot more pepper. I should be perfect now. I think I'm gonna have to come on down here and eat this stuff now. So I don't know if I ever showed you all my bacon and sausage. So we're just going to do it like this. I'm just going to turn one over like that so you can see it.